A very good day to each and everyone. Welcome to Alnaz Academy for part 13 of chapter 1, Reproduction in Lower and Higher Plants, class 12 Biology, revised syllabus 2020 of Maharashtra State Board, which also covers NCERT unit 6 chapter 2. And I am your facilitator Nusrat Siddiqui. To help you and to guide you, having experience of more than 15 years in the field of teaching. Let's begin our video with yet another inspiring quote by Helen Keller. Optimism is a faith that leads to achievement. Nothing can be done without hope and confidence. That means optimism by definition is hopefulness, confidence about the future, or the successful outcome of something. It is super easy to be negative these days, especially with Corona around, especially if you are in pain, emotionally hurting, or just plain not happy with wherever you are or where you are right now. Optimism is something we all need more of. It doesn't mean that we should live in fantasy land, but keeping in the faith and hope that good things come. On that note, let's start our today's topic, which is development of embryo. Let's do a quick recap as to what we have studied in our previous video. We have studied about the development of endosperm and the different types of endosperm, and these different types of endosperm were nuclear, cellular, helobial endosperm, then mosaic, ruminate, zinia and metazinia. This I have explained it in detail in my previous video. Let us first understand what do we mean by embryogenesis. Embryogenesis is the process of development of zygote into an embryo, and it is called as embryogenesis. And this takes place at the micropylar end of the embryo sac. The growth of the embryo triggers only after a certain amount of endosperm is formed, and after fertilization, embryonic development begins. Now we are going to study about dicot embryo. We know that zygote is formed by the fusion of male and female gamete, and it is diploid in nature, that is 2N. Over here we have marked M for micropylar end and C for chalazal end. It is important to know the positions of the cell formed during the cell division. So this zygote undergoes one mitotic cell division, resulting in the formation of two cells. The cell towards the micropyle is called as basal cell, and the cell towards the chalazal end is called as terminal cell. When we see the anatropous ovule, the cell at the base is called as basal cell, and the cell towards the chalaza is called as terminal cell. That is, the upper cell is called as terminal cell and the lower cell is called as basal cell. Lower cell or the basal cell is towards the micropyle. The terminal cell is towards the chalazal end. Now over here, since we are talking about the most common ovule, that is anatropous ovule, the lower is basal and upper is terminal. But if we are talking about the autotropous ovule, in this case, in case of autotropous ovule, the upper cell is the basal cell and the lower cell is the terminal cell. Why? Because the basal cell is towards the micropyle, and in orthotropous ovule, micropyle is above, and the lower cell is the terminal cell because terminal cell is towards the chalazal end, and in orthotropous ovule, chalaza is below. That's the reason why it is important to mark the positions of micropyle and chalaza to understand where the cell division and which type of cell is being formed. So, to remember easily, the cell which is at the micropylar end is basal cell. The cell which is at the chalazal end is the terminal cell. We know that now the cell has undergone one mitotic division, basal cell at the micropyle and terminal cell at the chalazal end. Now this basal cell will undergo many transverse division, forming a long structure, and this long structure is known as suspensor. The cell which is towards the micropyle, it will grow a little bigger, and it is known as haustorial cell. The function of suspensor is to push the embryo deep into the endosperm. The terminal cell will also undergo cell division in all the plane. So this terminal cell will undergo division in all the planes. We get a mass of the embryo which is known as proembryo. It is first formed by two cells, then by four cells, and then it is also termed as pro embryo quadrant because four cells are formed. So the terminal cell gives rise to the embryo and the suspensor helps in pushing the embryo deep into the endosperm. So from the basal cell we get suspensor and hostorial cell. From the terminal cell we get the embryo. Initially it is pro-embryo quadrant. Why quadrant? Because there are four cells. 1, 2, 3, 4 cells are formed. To understand the role of suspensor, let us understand it by taking an example of endosperm of Anatropous ovule and the zygote. The zygote divides at the micropylar end. So over here the zygote will start dividing at the micropylar end and then the suspensor is formed which elongates and pushes the embryo into the nutritive tissue, that is the endosperm. So over here the suspensor elongates and it pushes the embryo into the endosperm and this endosperm is the nutritive tissue. So this is the function of suspensor. There are four cells in the proembryo and that is the reason why it is termed as proembryo quadrant. Now this proembryo will further divide and will form 8 cell and then it will be termed as proembryo octant. Now the suspensor will remain as it is but proembryo will start looking a little bigger. It is mass like structure or a ball like structure where few cells are visible from the front and few cells are visible from behind. The cell doesn't look like this, the proembryo doesn't look like this, but we are drawing all the cells in order to understand the fate of all the cell. The cell which is in direct contact with the proembryo, it acts as hypophysis. One more division in the proembryo and this time the division is periclinal, resulting in the formation of the outer cells and the inner cell. So there will be a ring of outer cell and there will be a ring of inner cell. The ring of outer cell will give rise to dermatogen which will give rise to epidermis. The next change which we see is in hypophysis where it divides and it forms 8 cells and the suspensor and hostorial cells remains as it is. At this stage the embryo is known as globular embryo. The four cells which are towards the suspensor will give rise to root cap and root tip. The upper cell, that is the one which is in contact with the proembryo. So the upper four cells which are in contact with the proembryo will give rise to the root cortex. Now the half of the proembryo which is towards the micropylar end will give rise to hypocotyle. And the other half of the proembryo which is towards the chalazal end will give rise to cotyledon and epicotyle. I repeat again, this is the schematic representation. The actual embryo doesn't look like this. It is just to understand which part of the embryo forms what. The lower four cells of the hypophysis will divide to form root cap and root tip and almost the radical like structure and the upper cell will form the root cortex. So the lower four cells forms root cap and root tip and the upper four cells forms the root cortex. The cell of the embryo which is towards the micropyle, this part, the half of the proembryo, the cell of the proembryo which is towards the micropyle stays connected to the hypophysis and divides and forms a mass of the cell forming hypocotyle. The upper half divides and forms the cotyledon and plumule arise from the middle part. So we get a somewhat bulging structure and these bulging structures are cotyledon. The shape now formed somehow looks like heart-like structure and this is known as heart-shaped embryo and plumule is formed in the middle of the cotyledon. So now we have got a heart-shaped embryo. So the first shape which we have seen was globular. The second shape is heart-shaped embryo. Now since there is no enough space for the cotyledon to grow, it bends like this. And thus it forms a horseshoe-shaped embryo. This is also called as matured embryo. So cotyledons, they bend like this. When we see a dicot pea seed and remove the seed coat, we see the embryonal axis. Embryonal axis is not this big, but to understand it better, we are drawing it little bigger. We also see fleshy cotyledon. The tip towards the chalaza is the plumule. The tip towards the micropyle is the radical. The area where the cotyledon are attached to the embryonal axis is called as cotyledonary node. And the area between the cotyledonary node and plumule is called as epicotyle. Similarly, the area between the cotyledonary node and radical is known as hypocotyle. Now we know that radical part, the part of the radical is formed from hypophysis. Hypocotyle is developed from the lower part of the proembryo, which is towards the micropylar end. The two cotyledon, plumule and epicotyle is from the upper part of the proembryo, which is towards the chalazal end. Let us now understand the development of monocot embryo. So we know that zygote is a diploid zygote which is formed by the fusion of male and female gamete. Now this zygote will divide mitotically forming three cells. How these three cells are formed? Over here the cell will divide first to form two cell, and of this two cell one cell will divide to form the third cell. So the cell at the micropylar end is called as basal cell, the cell towards the chalazal end is called as terminal cell, and the middle cell is termed as middle cell. The basal cell will enlarge and will help in the absorption of the nourishment. The middle cell will divide and will give rise to almost all the parts of the embryo, and the division of this cell taking place in this cell will be in all the direction and a mass will be formed. The terminal cell will give rise to one cotyledon. So the terminal cell forms one cotyledon. The middle cell will form embryo, that means plumule, radical, epicotyle, hypocotyle, and also the suspensor is formed from the middle cell, and the basal cell is formed and it is used for the absorption of the nourishment. The basal cell will remain circular and large. The middle cell will grow and will give rise to radical and plumule. Attached to the basal cell will be suspensor. Now this suspensor will not be as big as it was in the dicot, and the terminal cell will form the cotyledon. Radical is covered with a sheet which is called as coleorrhiza. Same is the case with the plumule. Plumule is also covered with a sheet which is called as coleoptile. The part to which the cotyledon is attached, it is called as cotyledonary node, and the part between the cotyledonary node and coleoptile is called as epicotyle. The part between the cotyledonary node and coleorrhiza is known as hypocotyle. The cotyledon in case of monocot and especially in grasses, they are thin and papery and they are termed as scutellum. So cotyledon in case of monocot are thin, papery, especially in grasses, and they are termed as scutellum. The basal cell and the suspensor, it degenerates and the structure looks like this. So when we see a monocot grain, we see that there are two compartments in the grain, and the smaller compartment and the larger compartment. The larger compartment contains endosperm. The outer layer of the endosperm is made up of protein layer, which is of allurome, and the middle portion is the starchy endosperm. And the embryo is placed in the smaller compartment. The cotyledon is thin and papery, and thus the reserve food material in the cotyledon is negligible. Now as compared to dicotyledon, the dicotyledon were thick and fleshy and they contained the reserve food material for the growing embryo. But in case of monocotyledon, the cotyledon is thin and papery and there is negligible food material for the growing embryo. Thus, the digestive material of the endosperm passes to the cotyledon, and through the cotyledon it reaches the embryo. Thus, we have seen the development of embryo both in dicot and monocot and the differences in the development of these embryo as well. That's all for today. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions, do write to me at alnazacademyofficial@gmail.com. An entire playlist will be uploaded soon. So till we meet next time, stay safe, stay positive. Do like, subscribe and share this video with your friends so that they may also benefit. Till we meet next time, take care, bye-bye, thank you and happy learning.